Mm, so good.
Oh no.
Y'all know I love to eat, and I recently found out that Etsy sells food. Did you guys know that? I thought it was just for like homemade quilts and Christmas ornaments. I'm kind of nervous because I don't know where the snacks come from, but I'm also kind of excited because I love homemade stuff, and there's nothing like a grandma or an Aunt Jeanette's homemade warm banana nut bread. Maybe this is gonna open my eyes to a whole other world of snacks that I just never dipped my toe into, or my tongue, and I'm so very excited, can you tell? The only problem is I ordered these like several weeks ago and they came in 7 to 10 days later, and they've been sitting here for a while, so I don't know if it's moldy or gone bad. So we will have some challenges along the way, but I think there's gonna be more excitement than mold. Let's hope. The first thing that I ordered were homemade vanilla marshmallows. I don't buy marshmallows because I just think they're kind of weird. They're weird texture. I think the flavor's okay when it's mixed with Rice Krispies. Kind of just like a weird food item. But if marshmallows went away, would anyone even notice? Probably not. This is from Sweet Cravings Candy Company. Should I wash my hands? Well, if I have something, I'm not gonna give myself. It's too late already, you know? These, you guys, are so sticky. They look so good. Look at how yummy that, ooh. Smells really good. It smells like a campfire. Wow, this is so good. This is incredible. In your mouth, so good. I need to make Rice Krispie treats with this immediately. Excuse me while I take a moment, another moment. How do you even make marshmallows? Like, what is it even made of? If you have like a winter holiday, birthday, or Christmas gift, this with some hot cocoa and a little bundle together, oh my gosh, perfection. Oh my gosh, I can't tell anyone about that. Let's go into the hazelnut whiskey sandwich cookies from this place called Whimsy and Spice. These are bittersweet scotch whiskey infused dark chocolate nestled between two crunchy cookies studded with ground hazelnuts and chocolate chips. What more could you want? Literally nothing. There's nothing else you could fit in here. A handmade in small batches in Brooklyn, New York. So cute.
Mmm. Guys, everything is good.
Even when things are bad in the world, there are moments where it just feels like everything's gonna be okay, and I just had that moment. I don't love dark chocolate. It's not really my favorite. I like milk chocolate. Dark chocolate is for people who watch what they eat, which I do not. Dark chocolate is for people with refined palates, which I do not have. So it's rare that dark chocolate gets me this way. The cookie is soft, but also crunchy. So it's crumbly, but not like it's gonna cut your mouth. The dark chocolate has whiskey in it. I had boozy cake pops at my wedding, and it reminds me of those. I don't know if you can get drunk before you gain 20 pounds from eating these, but it's so good. It's really fresh tasting. Wow. These taste homemade. This tastes like you're at the family reunion. Aunt Patricia made these for you because she knows how much you love them. I bet you if I microwave this for 10 seconds, my brain would explode. So I'm not gonna do that because I do have some life left to live. These are the brownies. These are the espresso dulce de leche brownies. I hope they're not moldy. I love a brownie. Okay, they're a little harder. I should have eaten them right when they got delivered to me. Yep, these are probably old. I think this is not fresh, but I ate it anyway. If it was fresh, I would love this. It has like hints of espresso. It's just really good. It tastes crap. I just waited too long before eating it. So I think that's a learning lesson. If you order stuff from Etsy, like once it arrives, you probably should eat it right away. And the sad thing is I wanted these many times and I just never ate it because I wanted to save it for this video. Now I saved it for the video. Now it's too old and now it's gross. And this breaks my heart. There were only two things in here that were old, and I think this one's gonna be old, but I have a confession to make. This is a apricot almond bread. When I ordered this, two came, and so I did actually already try this with Matt. Even though I think this is moldy and I probably can't eat it at this point, I can speak to how it tasted, because as soon as bread arrives to my house, it's over. It's over for me and it. It still smells good. I don't know if I should eat this. Would you eat 2-week-old homemade almond nut butter bread. I am gonna show you guys why I didn't love it. It was really tasty, and it kind of tasted like homemade southern pound cake. I thought that the apricot element of the apricot almond butter would be more blended into the mixture, but there's kind of like chunky apricots inside of the bread, which I personally don't like. Because it kind of reminds me of like a raisin texture, and I hate raisins. This is a personal preference. Matt thought it was a good version of what it was. It's just like not a thing that I would order again. It's really cutely presented, and it feels like something you would give your grandmother for, I don't know, her birthday or something. That's it for the old food. The rest of the food is still good. Moving on to something that I am so nervous about. I'm so nervous about this. This is a Carolina Reaper extra hot salsa. It has wanted on the label, which that's how you know it's bad. It's for bad girls. A lot of you know I'm from North Carolina, and the Carolina Reaper pepper has a reputation for being one that can take a grown person down. My grandpa grew Carolina Reaper peppers in his garden. He renamed them Peter peppers because when he would go pick them, he would forget that he would go pick them and then have to go pee, and he would touch his little thing. I'm trying not to get my video demonetized. Then feel like his private area was gonna
burn off.
And so he renamed the Carolina Reaper the Peter Pepper. Not sure why I know that story about my grandfather, but can't wait to eat it now. I never tried the Carolina Reaper pepper. Okay, it just kind of smells like hot salsa. I'm really nervous right now. Carolina Reaper is no joke. Oh no. What if it's bad? I'm gonna get a nice little dollop. Can you guys see that? So you know that I'm actually eating it. I don't want to hear any comments in the comments. I can do this. Oh no, immediate. I can't speak. Oh my God, what do I do? I don't know what to do, I'm alone. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, what do I do? All right, everyone, we're back. I don't know if we're as good as we were before we left. It has been like 15 minutes. I'm still not over it. Okay, I'm gonna move on to this cinnamon stick simple syrup. I think my brain is melting. I was the most excited about this because I feel like tasty syrups make a very basic coffee drink or cocktail taste extra delicious. And it makes me want to not buy coffee because I have specialty coffee stuff at my house. I brewed a cup of coffee and I'm just, oh, it smells so good. Oh, you guys. Oh, it smells like Big Red Gum. Does that still exist? It smells like the holidays. It smells like those like scented pine cones at Joann Fabrics. How am I gonna get this into this without causing a big stir? No pun intended, because I'm gonna stir it. A little. Oh, that was a lot. We made our bed, we shall lie in it again. Ooh, that's really good. Oh, I love this stuff, you guys. This is so tasty. Buy that, please. Buy it right now. I'll link it in the description. Buy this, it's so good. If you love coffee, if you love making coffee, if you have an espresso machine or you're like a foamer and you wanna up your coffee game, this is so good. This next treat is Boondock Enterprises pecan, or pecan if you're from where I'm from in North Carolina, pecan pie jam. Has sugar, apple juice, pecans, nectar, or no, that's vinegar, not nectar. Extract and spices. Oh, manufactured by Michael and Dawn. Hey y'all, you're not even from the South. You're like, why are you saying y'all to us? Do you guys see that? It's so chunky, it's so thick. All those pecans. Oh my gosh, it smells kind of like not good. It kind of smells like an old closet. I don't really know what to eat this with, so I got some plain crackers. I mean, it is not pureed at all. It's so chunky. Mmm. Oh, so good. Oh my gosh. Oh, it's like pecan pie in a jar. There's like one little tart thing in there. So it's not super sweet, which I like about it. Oh my gosh, this would be so good on a biscuit, y'all. I need a biscuit. Oh yeah. It smells terrible. Why does it smell so terrible but taste so good?
I thought this was gonna be like jammy and jelly, but it's so, I love that. I love that it's chunky. This is dangerous because my brain doesn't register it as a dessert, but my mouth does. I could probably eat this entire jar with a spoon. That's how good this is. I feel emotional. I feel wounded. I feel full. I feel happy. I know that some of my stuff got old and stale, but even if they were fresh, I think my favorite would still be the pecan pie jam, the cinnamon stick simple syrup, so good. The hazelnut sandwich cookies were so good. The marshmallows, how could I forget you? You guys, Etsy has amazing food. I had no idea. This was like a whole new world for me. Have you guys tried any food from Etsy in the past? Let me know. I also saw candied bacon, but I was a little too scared to take that leap. And if you guys want to see me try Emma Chamberlain, she just came out with a new coffee. I tried her coffee and compared it to a bunch of other coffee places right here to see which one was best. I did a celery cleanse this year and the results were pretty shocking. You should click here to watch that. The Carolina Reaper salsa is only a gag gift for someone who tells you that things aren't spicy enough. I feel like I was just abused through mastication.